Are you serious? Are you serious? Get a cup of coffee. Calm down. But it looks like it might be going to happen. A prophecy alert, a biblical prophecy alert. We have information coming out of the White House that on Sunday, December 3rd, it looks like President Donald J. Trump may be going to make the announcement that the United States Embassy that is in Tel Aviv may be moving to Jerusalem. We have rumors coming out of Washington on today, the 70th anniversary of Israel becoming a non-member state, voted on in the United Nations back on today, November 29th, 1947. And the rumors are swirling. What a year. The 100th year of the Balfour Declaration, the 50th year of Israel's reunification of the city of Jerusalem, and the 70th anniversary of the vote that made Israel a state. And then in May 14th, in next year of 2018, will be 70th anniversary of Israel as a nation. Well, the Bible, this is a prophecy alert, in Psalms 48, you might say, what's the big deal about them moving the embassy? Because if the United States moves the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, then they are declaring that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. And that changes everything, because the Palestinians, matter of fact, Rome, the Vatican, refuses to acknowledge Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. Matter of fact, the United Nations doesn't want to acknowledge it. But if the United States makes this move, the president was there back in May, and everyone said he's going to do this. Well, here's what the Bible says in Psalms 48. God is the Lord, and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. Beautiful for situation, the joy of the whole earth is Mount Zion. On the sides of the north, the city of the great king. Capital K-I-N-G. We're not talking about King David either. We're talking about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. This is a prophecy alert. This will declare it. And think about this. David said this about 800 years before Jerusalem was destroyed. Look, David said this. We didn't even have a temple. Solomon hasn't even built the temple yet. And that temple gets destroyed in 586 BC. Then it's rebuilt by King Herod. It gets destroyed by the Roman empires in 70 AD. And then Israel doesn't become a nation until 70 years ago. It was finally declared a state, and it became a nation in 1948. And then it took 50 years before Jerusalem could be reunified. And that happened in 1967. 50 years ago. And now, all 3,000-year-old prophecy is on the verge of being fulfilled. Folks, Donald Trump, who would have ever dreamed, may be the man that fulfills this prophecy by declaring that the U.S. Embassy is going to be moved to Jerusalem, signifying that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. Now, the United States Congress originally voted on this in 1995 and declared that it was the capital of Israel and that they were moving the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. But then President Bill Clinton put a stop on it and said, hold it a minute. This could cause tensions between the Jews and the Palestinians. Let's put a 6-month hold on that decision. And every year, every 6 months, the presidents have stopped it. Bill Clinton did many times. George W. Bush did his entire 8 years. Barack Obama did his entire 8 years. And even President Trump did in January, or whenever it was, just after he became president, sometime in May, he did it. He said, let's wait 6 more months. We might be ready come December. So let's see what happens. Will he get a lot of pressure to not do it? Yes, he will. But this is one of his campaign promises. And I believe he will do this before this first term is over. We're going to wait and see if he's able to keep it. And he may. Rumors are that the proclamation may be made this coming Sunday. We'll be talking about this. This is huge. This is huge. And another thing about this is, I'm going to tell you why. Because once Jerusalem is made the capital of Israel, officially by the world, it fulfills this scripture. It's the city of the great king. Then you can go to Zechariah chapter 14, and you can read about how Israel comes under attack. Jerusalem comes under attack. Actually, it's called the cup of trembling in Zechariah 12, and that how the whole world's going to come against it. And then in Zechariah 14, it says that there'll be an invasion of Jerusalem, trying to divide the city, and it will look like the city will almost fall. And then the Lord, his feet will stand in that day upon the Mount of Olives, which is before Jerusalem on the east, and the Mount of Olives shall have an earthquake that splits the Mount of Olives. And it's an incredible earthquake. And after the earthquake is over, and once the people realize that what they were doing, coming against Jerusalem, was going to bring curses upon the land, there is there's the temple they has built, obviously, because in verse 16, this is Zechariah 14, 16, here's the scripture. And it shall come to pass that everyone that is left of all the nations which came against Jerusalem shall even go up from year to year to worship the king, capital K-I-N-G. The Lord of hosts, that's Jesus Christ, that's Yeshua, that is the Messiah. They will come up every year. Whoever's left on the earth, who's still around, remnant from the different nations, will come to Jerusalem every year to worship the King, the Lord of hosts, and to keep the Feast of Tabernacles. And it shall be that whosoever will not come up of all the families of the earth unto Jerusalem to worship the King, the Lord of hosts, even upon them shall be no rain. In other words, famine, desolence, and poverty will come upon them and their families. This is the scriptures. These scriptures have never been fulfilled, folks. Zechariah 12, Zechariah 14, the splitting of the Mount of Olives, the worshiping of the king, that's never happened, but it will. And so even as you know, the Antichrist will one day walk into that temple and declare he's God. Well, you have to understand, before he ever does that, there'll be a time when people will come to the city of Jerusalem to worship Yeshua. No, they're not going to be worshiping. I know there's going to be this one that they're going to come to Jerusalem to worship a one world religion. No, they won't. They'll be worshiping the king. It says it in the Bible, the king, the Lord of hosts. All right. Now, later, after Yeshua has been recognized, after he has been worshiped, after the tabernacle has been blessed, then we know the Antichrist will appear. And when he appears, he will bring the abomination of desolation. Jesus said that's coming in the end times, the last days. Well, folks, we are so close now. We're just about ready to make Jerusalem the city of the great king. And we know that all of the pieces and parts of the building of the temple are so close to being done, which means you're going to see these biblical prophecies starting to come to pass. You got Psalms 83, you got Ezekiel 38, you got Zechariah 12, Zechariah 14. I mean, you're moving soon. The two witnesses are going to appear. After the temple is built, you're going to see the two witnesses. They will be part of the reason people come to Jerusalem to worship the king, because they will be in sackcloth and ashes preaching in the streets of Jerusalem. You can read it for yourself. It's right there in Revelation chapter 11. It talks about the blueprints of the third temple. It talks about the two witnesses. It talks about the mighty move of God. It talks about the whole world hating these two preachers. And it says that they will bring plagues upon the earth, and as often as they want to, it won't rain in some areas. They'll turn the water into blood. They'll bring plagues upon the earth, and they'll finally be killed. And the Bible says once the two witnesses are killed, they will leave their bodies in the streets for 3.5 years, and then the spirit of life will enter back into them. God will raise them from the dead. The whole world will see it, even on fake news CNN. And as they rise from the dead, the whole world will be stunned. They will be raptured into heaven, and the whole world will know. And then an earthquake will come, and it will kill 7,000 people in the city of Jerusalem. And that's the earthquake that Zechariah says is going to be hitting the earth in the 14th chapter of Zechariah. It's the same earthquake in Revelation 11. Are you serious? I told you, things are going to accelerate. If the president of the United States announces they're moving the embassy, watch for chaos, watch for the whole Palestinian thing blow up for a little bit, but it'll simmer down after a while. But I'm telling you, that announcement will fulfill Psalms 48 and will kick things into gear in these end times. Are you serious? I'm going to talk about it tonight. Don't miss tonight's Prime Time Live. I'll be on at 10 p.m. Eastern at right here on YouTube and everywhere else. My website, paulbegleyprophecy.com. 10 p.m. Eastern tonight. Prophecy alert.